let's watch some TikToks. So make sure you subscribe. You gotta click again for the bell notification. Otherwise, I'm like dark matter and you won't be able to see me anywhere. Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. We'll talk more about Squarespace later in the video. That's like a cold atom top trap. Moral of the story, you could learn to ride a horse as long as it spins around like a tornado. What is this? Why does she have hashtag physics?
And so I believe in the conservation of energy. So I know that if I let it go, it's gonna go away and not come back and hit me, right? So now I want you to show me if you believe
I'm just waiting for the day someone does this wrong and accidentally pushes it.
So now let's bring this back. Let's back up a little. Okay, ready?
Today is not the day.
No, right, wait, so. Now, don't hold your hands out. Now, let go. Let go. I'll hold it. Do you believe in the conservation of energy?
Yes.
Don't shake your head. Don't move your head at all. Okay. Ready? Don't flinch. Do you believe? I believe. Oh, she did it. She did it.
Brave. Not bad. When you've studied physics for years like me, you can actually do things like this. Patience, my young Padawan. To become Jedi, master physics you must. To master physics, nerd you must become. Thus, nerd equals Jedi.
Ruler, on the table.
On the table.
You drop something on it, it's gonna fall.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But if you put an ordinary piece of paper on the ruler over here, just put it like that, and you drop something.
The reason why when she puts a paper on there it doesn't do it is because of air pressure. So you've got all of that air above the piece of paper on it, top of it. That's why this works. So it's just air pressure. And you can do the same experiment and break like a wooden ruler this way. If you hit it hard enough, it'll actually break the wooden ruler. So you might think because it's out of frame, she might have like put something on the other side, but look, let's go another version. Just so you guys can believe this.
Did you know the solar system is shaped like a croissant?
Is it really?
The sun creates this protective bubble around the planets in our solar system called the heliosphere. Except it's not a sphere. It used to be believed to be shaped like a comet's tail, but now it's more like a croissant. And the model that produced this result is based off observations and theoretical astrophysics. So, yeah.
This video is making me hungry, Kirsten. Before we get onto the next TikTok, excuse me whilst I go find a croissant. Okay, no croissant, but I have something even better. I found a cookie. So, I'm gonna eat this cookie and we're gonna watch some more TikToks. All right, this one looks fun. One weird trick if you're feeling
If you're ever
down.
Feeling sad or depressed about the state of the world, here's one weird trick that always works for me.
Get in a car.
Drive to the border of France and Switzerland.
Descend 50 meters underground.
This guy's awesome.
And remind yourself that humanity is still capable of incredible things.
It's all fun and games until the entire MCU comes through. Why does our universe exist? Can't help you with that one. Mystery hut on the moon.
Okay, what's with this mystery hut on the moon business? China's U-2 rover has spotted this odd, apparently cube-shaped hut while roving on the far side of the moon. And China has informally named it Shenmi Xiaowu, meaning mystery hut.
It's definitely a monolith.
Now, is it actually a hut?
Yes.
Probably not. Most likely it's a boulder.
Definitely a rock.
Just like when this face on Mars turned out to be just a flat hill. But U-2 is slowly making its way towards this mystery hut over the next few lunar days. Where a lunar day is equivalent to 29 days, 12 hours, and 44 minutes on Earth. So we can expect to get more information about this mystery hut early in the new year.
And it was a rock. Good call, Astro Kirsten. Okay, someone sent me this video and told me there's physics in it.
I was the Island Boys High School teacher.
Very nice young men. This is Alex, a.k.a. Fly Soldier. And before he wanted to be a rap star, Alex actually brought in a little NASA astronaut shuttle to career day. And he said he wanted to live on a star. It was at that point that his brother started to yell at him, explaining that stars were made of gas and that he would burn up. That really upset Alex, so they got into a physical altercation. I had these two kids rolling around the floor, punching one another, arguing about the physics of a star and whether or not you could actually inhabit it.
Well, there you go. One of the Island Boys was an aspiring physicist.
Hey, everybody. James here at CERN. Come here. You gotta see this. So, you know how I'm always talking about these gigantic magnets that we have here at CERN? You know, the 1,200 dipole magnets that we put 100 meters underground into the 27-kilometer circular tunnel of the Large Hadron Collider, each of which has a magnetic field that's 100,000 times greater than the Earth's magnetic field. And these are the only things that allow us to accelerate protons to the highest energy that humans have ever used in a collider experiment to explore the mysteries of the universe. This is where the magnets are born. When the magnets are nearly ready, they look something like this. And then they undergo a whole series of tests and trainings before eventually they end up in those blue tubes that are lowered 100 meters underground to the Large Hadron Collider tunnel.
You should make an explainer.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Those dipole magnets are like one of the most complex parts of the LHC. They basically bend and align the trajectories of the particles and keep it stable. Believe it or not, these aren't even the strongest magnets in the world. And I think the largest one in the world currently is powerful enough to pick up an aircraft carrier. It is for the heart of the largest fusion reactor in the world, ITER, which means the way in Latin. So for the other physicists and Mandalorians out there, this is the way. This is why high-powered can magnets be dangerous. I had a stroke this reading. But yeah, magnets are dangerous, guys. Be careful.
We can create art objects by using potato physics. Everyone knows that plastic straws are not sturdy enough to pierce a raw potato. But now I will use physics. I will cover the top of the straw with my finger.
I will
trap air in this straw. It will create pressure and will make the straw.
Dr. Tatiana again.
Oh, more. Much more. Mr. Bye-bye. Bob. Yeah, more.
Yeah, it seems boring.
It's great.
They're going up.
They're not going down.
Are those magic bubbles?
Yes.
It's physics. You can play music by a different diameter.
Spasiba, Dr. Tatiana. Dr. Tatiana for MVP of the planet. You just realized the speed of light ain't all that.
I can't even hit a ping pong ball that fast. Wait, what?
I could probably outrun that.
I thought light was fast.
Doesn't look that fast. Light is fast, but the universe is fast.
Everyone seems so confused, but if you grab the egg and you throw it, okay, it's bouncy, all right? It's bouncy. But then if you take the egg and you smash it, not that hard, it's just physics.
You should definitely try this experiment yourself.
What I'm about to show you is a picture from one of my first year physics lectures, where my lecturer asked me to come to the front of the classroom and do this. Sandwich him between two beds of nails and then stand on top of him. I can guarantee you that his trust was not with me that day. It was instead with physics. This lesson was in the distribution of forces. If I were to apply my weight force on one single nail on my lecturer, it will almost certainly pierce the skin and do some good damage. But when you apply that same force over multiple nails, the force on each individual nail decreases significantly, meaning that you barely make an indent in the skin. It's fine. And if this wasn't terrifying enough to do, he then asked me to put a block of concrete on it and then break it with a hammer. That was in front of 500 physics and engineering students.
Lucky you didn't get me to come stand on that board because I eat way too many of these things. Time to break physics. It's not exactly breaking physics. So how about you guys leave the correct answer in the comment section and I'll like the correct answer so you guys can check what the answer is.
And we'll let it go. Now you know that it's turning around in circles. You
In fact, if you look at it from above, you can see that it's turning around in a circle. But now your brain is doing something strange. It's telling you that it's not going around in a circle, but it's oscillating. In other words, it's turning part way, stopping, and then going back the other way. But if you think that's strange, wait till I add something through the middle. What am I going to add? Well, I'm going to add a ballpoint pen. But what's your brain going to tell you about the window? Will your brain allow you to see the window going around in a circle with the pen? Or are you going to see something really strange? Look at that.
This feels
that's
elite.
Unbelievable, isn't it? You can see the pen going around.
It's a glitch
in the
matrix, everyone.
But your brain is telling
I'm
you
just
that
trying
the
to figure out how the pen is balancing on that.
And turning
thing.
And going the other way. And yet, in order to do that, the two things have that's to pass cool. through one another, the pen and the window. You know it's not possible. You know it can't happen.
You want to see a neat physics
yes,
demonstration?
Yes, I do.
This plate on the left is currently loaded with positive charge, and the plate on the right has negative charge. Mm. Look what happens when I put this neutral ping pong ball in the middle.
Where did it go?
The ping pong
Am
ball
this
is painted in a metallic
teleportation?
Plate, making it a conductor. When it okay. touches the positive plate, it becomes positively charged. Yes. That attracts
really
the negative
annoying.
Plate, then becomes
but
negative
very cool,
charge.
Nonetheless. So someone asked, why is this not a perpetual motion machine? Well, every time the ball touches the plates, it takes a little bit of the charge. Eventually, the plates lose all their charge and the ball stops. The reason why it doesn't look like that here is that these plates are probably continuously receiving charge. So you're not getting energy just from nothing. If you haven't already, why not start a Squarespace website? It's never been easier. From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is an all-in-one platform that'll allow you to create a beautiful online presence and run your business. Via our partnership, we offer a year-long comp service. Take advantage of this for your read as well as for yourself. They have all sorts of really cool features. One of which I think is really cool is their member-only content. They're called Squarespace Member Areas, and you can connect with your audience, and with the content you provide on it, you can generate revenue. You can also manage your members, send email communications, and leverage audience insights all in one easy platform. Another great feature of Squarespace are the email campaigns. You can grow and engage with your audience through these Squarespace email campaigns, and they allow you to create content that matches your website, your logo, existing products, blog posts, so your messaging is consistent and effective. And finally, another great feature of Squarespace is that you can collect donations. You can support your cause by gathering contributions with PayPal, Apple Pay, Stripe, and Venmo. Check out squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/DillandJDance to get 10% off your first purchase on a website or domain. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Also, go send me some TikToks on Instagram.